All right, students, in this lecture, we're going to learn website security tips. Like many modern software packages, WordPress is updated regularly to address new security issues that may arise. However, reinforcing your website will thwart hacker evil doers. Let's get started. The first thing we're going to go over is downloading iTheme security. iTheme security gives you over 30 ways to secure and protect your WordPress website. On average, about 30,000 new websites are hacked each day. WordPress sites can be easy target for attackers because of plugin vulnerabilities, weak passwords, and obsolete software. Most WordPress admins don't even know they're vulnerable. But iTheme security works to fix common holes, stop automated attacks, and strengthen user credentials. Let's go ahead and download iThemes to our website. Visit your website dashboard by going to the URL /wp-admin and logging in. That should bring you to your website dashboard area. Then scroll down to plugins and hit add new. We're gonna go ahead and download the iTheme security plugin to our website. Just make a search and go iThemes security. Also, as a side note, iTheme security is a totally free plugin, which also has premium features. But for what we're doing, you can do a great job with the free version. Now I've already installed it. So what you're going to do is hit install and it should complete. Then activate. Once you hit install, you should get an additional option on the left-hand side at the bottom that says security. Now when you click that, hit the dashboard. That'll bring you to the iTheme security dashboard. The first time you go into the plugin, it's going to give you some important first steps. Now you always want to back up your site before you make any changes. You can either use the other plugin that we installed prior, or you can make a backup through the iTheme security plugin. Let's go ahead and do that. Next, you want to allow file updates. Many of the functions of the plugin require editing of your WP config files, so you have to give access to it to go ahead and do that automatically. Go ahead and hit allow file updates. Now the one-click secure takes care of minor and medium features on your website that cannot conflict with other plugins or themes. These are quick ways to secure your website. Let's hit that also. You can also give iTheme security help in creating this awesome plugin by allowing iThemes to collect anonymous data from you. I highly recommend this as they offer this valuable plugin for free. It doesn't hurt to help them out. Let's hit yes, I'd like to help. Once that's done, you've done a lot of the preliminary measures, go ahead and hit dismiss. The first thing you want to do is temporarily whitelist your IP address. Now we're going to set up individual security settings in the settings tab. First thing you do is hit settings. Scroll down. You can go ahead and choose your email for all of your notifications. This means backups or any problems or issues with your website will go directly to this email address. Usually it just defaults to the main one on your WordPress website. Go ahead and keep scrolling down. You don't have to really worry about any of these items. Now when you're scrolling, for 404 detection, go ahead and hit this. This looks at a user who is hitting a large number of non-existent pages and getting a large number of 404 errors on your website. A 404 error is when someone visits a specific page on your website that doesn't exist. So if your website was google.com and you had google.com/JohnJohn and that wasn't a web page that you created, then you would get a 404 error. And those can cause problems when it comes to your website. And if your website is getting a lot of 404 detections in a short period of time, that means someone is scanning for something and you want to block that individual. As you scroll, check off enable ban users. This will allow you to completely ban hosts and users from your website without having to manage any configuration on your server. For now, we'll leave it blank. If you keep scrolling, file change detection will tell you what files have changed in your WordPress installation, alerting you to changes not made by yourself. Unlike other solutions, this plugin will only look at your installation and compare files to the last check instead of comparing them with a remote installation, thereby taking into account whether or not you modify the files yourself. I highly suggest you click that. You can leave additional options alone. Hide login area is super important. This hides the login page, making it harder to find by automated attacks and making it easier for users unfamiliar with the WordPress platform. Usually, with WordPress websites, you can get to the admin area by putting in the URL followed by /wp-admin. This allows you to make a definite change to your login slug, so it's something that's difficult and not easy for these automated viruses to get into your website. So mine, I'm going to do ultimate webd login area. Now, instead of putting in ultimatewebd.com/WP login to get to my dashboard, I'm going to put in ultimatewebd.com/ultimatewebdlogin area. Make sure to record this in your Google Drive with your password list. Also, enable directory browsing, protect system files, and lastly, reduce comment spam. Once you hit those items, hit the Save All Changes button. Once you do that, you'll always get a pop-up of your new admin URL. Make sure you save this for your records. It's super important to remember this, as it's the only way to get back into your website once you change WP-admin. So just save that to your drive. Once that's done, you're going to hit dashboard. If you scroll down the list, you can see the security status of most of our items. If we click completed, we've done a majority of the items on the list. However, you can get more granular by looking at medium and high priority. Let's hit all to see them in one list. High priority, malware scanning is not enabled. But you don't really have to worry about too much because this is a basic security. We don't need to beef it up as much. Our site is performing scheduled backups, but it's through an additional plugin, so we don't really have to fix that either. Now, if you go to medium priority, these are some of the things that you can do. I don't suggest these just because it manipulates some of the files on your website and can mess up some of the and can change some of the configurations. The only one I would fix is adding an additional user ID. Now, since we already encrypted our admin and our password by using a pretty long username and an encrypted password, we don't really have to worry about this priority as well. Honestly, these are items that should be secured if possible. However, they're not critical to the overall security of the site. So I wouldn't worry about these medium priority items. We've already completed most of the medium and high priority items. The last thing we want to do is do a site check to make sure that our website's clean and running efficiently. Google Security Site Check and hit enter. At the top, click the first organic listing. Here you can do a scan of your website for free. It'll check it for malware, blacklisting status, meaning when the search engines blacklist you because your content or your website has a virus. It'll also scan for website errors and out-of-date software. Let's type our URL in there. Once it loads, you'll get site check results. Hopefully, all of your items are green, except for the last one, which is a website firewall. That's more so for e-commerce websites that have SSLs, which are security credentials that protect user data. That's something you won't have to worry about. You can also hit website details, which will give you information about your website, and blacklist status. And as you can see, our domain is clean on all browsers. Let's recap. All right. We downloaded iTheme Security. We make sure it worked by activating a lot of the items and a lot of the protection tips that were suggested. Once that was complete, we tested our website with the security site checker. All right, you're all set and your website's locked down.